Welcome to the protocol video for WHONDRS ICON-ModEx river surface water and sediment sampling. Please read the written protocol before sampling. It contains critical details. And if there are any discrepancies between this video and the written protocol you receive, follow the written protocol. WHONDRS will ship you a kit with your sampling materials. The sampling containers are pre-labeled. The first part of the label is the same across all your kit's materials. It is C, M, followed by three numbers. This is your kit ID. The second part of the label is unique to the type of sample being collected and may also indicate a replicate number. Pay attention to the written protocol when you're in the field so that you fill each container correctly. In the field, you will start by identifying a depositional zone where you plan to collect samples. Next, locate the oxygen sensor and metadata sheet included in your kit. Record the number written on the sensor housing to identify which sensor you deployed. Remove the soft black protective cap from the end of the sensor. Place the sensor upstream of your sampling location. This avoids contaminating the water going past the sensor as you sample sediment. Do your best to keep the sensor away from the sediment surface, and do not let the sensor disturb the water's surface. The goal is to measure the water column oxygen. Ideally, elevate the sensor off the riverbed at least 10 centimeters by setting it on a rock or sticking the white base vertically into soft sediment. If you have no choice, it is okay to lay the sensor on the riverbed. If needed, secure the sensor so it does not move downstream. On the metadata sheet, record the date, start time, and time zone for the sensor deployment. You will leave the sensor in the water while you sample. Now that the sensor is deployed, you can fill out the rest of your metadata, including the latitude and longitude of the sensor and information to describe your surroundings. You will also take a series of photographs that will be uploaded with your metadata. The photographs should have a measuring tape extended to 30 centimeters visible in the picture. Remember, for the two photos looking down at the sediment, hold the camera parallel to the ground. Next, measure the pH of the river water with the provided strip by dipping it into the water upstream of where you are standing. After 15 seconds, compare the color of the strip to the color chart provided and record the pH value on the metadata sheet. Measure the temperature of the water at 50% of the water column depth near where you plan to sample and record it on the metadata sheet. Measure the water depth near where you plan to sample and record it on the metadata sheet. You are now ready to begin collecting samples. Put on a clean pair of nitrile gloves and look through your sampling materials, grouping by the second half of the label. Put the 500 milliliter bottle marked as BSD and the two 50 milliliter tubes marked as MIC to the side. These are for sediment. The rest of the supplies are for water. You will collect these sediment samples at the end. Locate the three 60 milliliter amber vials labeled as ICR. These contain a very small volume of phosphoric acid. Wear safety glasses when collecting these samples and do not unscrew the vial lids. Also, locate the labeled filter, which is already attached to the needle. Open the package that has the filter and needle attached to each other, but leave everything else in the package for now. Open the 60 milliliter syringe package and remove the syringe. Stand downstream of the sampling location and point the syringe opening upstream. Fill the syringe with river water from 50% of the water column depth. Expel the syringe contents into the river downstream of the sampling location. Repeat this two more times. After flushing the syringe three times, fill the syringe again from 50% of the water column depth. This is the sample water you will be collecting. Screw the syringe onto the filter that has a needle connected to it. Remove the plastic cover that is protecting the needle. Please do not touch the outlet of the syringe, the inlet of the filter, or any part of the needle. This is important to avoid contamination. It is okay to touch the cylindrical filter housing. Now push 5 milliliters of water through the filter needle assembly and discard the water. Remove the flip top cap of the 60 milliliter amber vial to uncover the septum. Do not touch the septum. Push the needle through the septum and press on the syringe plunger to fill the vial to the pre-marked line. Shake the vial gently to incorporate the acid into the sample and then store the vial on ice. To prepare for the next replicate, unscrew the filter from the syringe and push out all the water from the syringe to discard. Then, refill the syringe from the river at 50% water column depth. Attach the filter and push at least 5 milliliters of water through the filter to push the new sample into the filter housing. Follow the previous steps to collect the second replicate, and then repeat for the third replicate. Remove the needle before moving on to the next vial type. Locate the 3 40-milliliter amber vials labeled as OCN and follow the same process described previously to fill them to the pre-marked line and store in the cooler. This should include removing the filter, emptying the syringe, refilling with new water, and pushing the new sample into the filter housing. Rather than filling the vials with a needle, hold the filter outlet above the opening of the vial and expel the water from above. Do not insert the filter outlet down inside the vial. To prepare for the next replicate, unscrew the filter from the syringe and push out all of the water from the syringe. Repeat the same steps to collect the second and third replicates. Repeat the same process for the tubes labeled with WIN. Repeat the same process for the opaque brown plastic bottle labeled as BWT and labeled as filtered. Fill the bottle to the neck. You will need to fill the syringe multiple times. At some point during filtering, your pre-labeled filter will clog. In a very turbid system, it may be when you are still filling the small vials. In a less turbid system, it may be when you are filling the large brown bottle. When your filter clogs, pause your current sampling step and preserve the filter. To preserve the labeled filter, detach the 60-milliliter syringe from the filter. Expel remaining water from the syringe and fill the syringe with air. Attach the air-filled syringe to the filter and push the air through the filter. The goal is to expel as much water from the filter as possible. Repeat 2 or 3 times if needed. There may be a small amount of water remaining. Take the female lure lock cap, dip it into the stream to rinse it, and then attach it to the outlet end of the filter. From the provided supplies, take out a small epi tube filled with RNA-laden preservative for the filter, the 3mm syringe, and a new needle. Connect the new needle to the 3mm syringe, then carefully open the small epi tube and fill the syringe with all the RNA-laden by putting the needle down into the liquid. After filling the syringe with RNA-laden, invert the syringe so that the needle is facing up. Safely discard the needle. Attach the 3mm syringe to the filter and rotate so that the syringe is facing down and the filter is below it. Push the plunger to slowly fill the filter with RNA-laden until you feel some resistance or until you have used all the RNA-laden. Locate the remaining lure lock cap, dip it into the stream to rinse it, and then attach it to the filter. Gently shake the sealed filter to distribute the RNA-laden. Put the capped filter into a small Whirlpack bag, tie up to seal, and place it in the cooler. Please ensure no water enters the Whirlpack bag. After your filter is preserved, attach a new filter to finish your filtered water sampling. Once you have filled the opaque brown plastic bottle labeled for filtered water, you will fill a bottle with unfiltered water. Find the bottle labeled BWT that lacks a label for filtered. Fill the bottle from approximately 50% water column depth. Fill the bottle to the neck and close. Store in the cooler with the other samples. Now that you have finished collecting water samples and the filter, you can move on to collecting sediment. For demonstration purposes, the following sediment collection will take place on dry land adjacent to the river. However, during your sediment collection, be sure to collect your samples underwater. You may receive small sieves to help separate fine-grained sediment from coarse sediment. If you receive a sieve, follow the instructions in the written protocol to collect the sediment into the bottle. Locate the sediment containers you set aside previously, labeled as BSD and MIC. Put on a new pair of nitrile gloves. Unwrap the scoop and scupula so that you only touch the handles and not the part that will come in contact with the samples. You can place them on the clean side of the foil if you need to set them down. Rinse the scoop and scupula in the river water. Use the scoop to collect surface sediments from a depth of 1 to 3 centimeters and drop the sediment down into the bottle from above the bottle. Avoid plant material and sediments larger than 4 millimeters. Try to collect as little excess water as possible. You can hold the scoopula against the scoop to retain sediments as you tip the scoop to drain water before putting the sediment into the bottle. To get enough material, it is okay to move around and collect sediments from across the depositional zone and even to move to additional nearby depositional zones with a similar physical setting and similar sediments. The most important thing is to fill the bottle with as much fine-grained sediment as possible. That is mostly less than 2 millimeters in diameter. Repeat the same process to drop sediment down into the two plastic tubes labeled MIC until the liquid and sediment mixture reaches the pre-marked line. Do not fill past the line. Be careful not to splash the liquid already in the tube. This is the preservative RNA later. After adding the sediment, close the tube and shake gently to mix. Store the sediment samples in the cooler and fill out the metadata sheet question that asks about sediment collection depth. Record the sensor end time on the metadata sheet. All of the fields should now be full, so you can photograph the sheet for upload with your other photographs. Remove the oxygen sensor from the water and replace the black cap. After collecting all of your samples, recording all the metadata, and retrieving the sensor, you are done in the field. Back at the lab, you should store your samples in the refrigerator, submit your digital metadata using the link in the protocol, and email WHONDRS at pnnl.gov to tell us you plan to ship your samples the next day. When you are ready to ship, pack your samples carefully using the ice packs provided and apply the prepaid FedEx label to the box. Thank you for sampling with WHONDRS. The data from these samples will be publicly available for you and others to use. Please remember to read the written protocol and reach out if you have any questions.